A mail merge allows you to send out a letter to multiple people, producing an individual document for each recipient so that each one is personalised. It can be useful for sending out anything from a few to several thousand letters. Here we're going to show you how you can use this feature to send out an email merge or eShot where the recipients are contacts stored in your Access database. When you do this, a separate email message is created for each individual so you can customize the contents of the email to each person, and there's no long list of recipients in the email so spam filters are not triggered. You can also follow a very similar process to email contacts stored in Excel. The Access database we'll be using as an example is the one from Accounts Guardian, a free piece of accounting software available for download on our website. Check the description for the full link. In this database, you can store information on your contacts, customers, suppliers, prospects, etc., in an address book. We're going to send an email to all of our customers telling them about a new service we offer. Before we start though, one thing we recommend is setting Outlook to send emails only when you do a manual send and receive. You can find the option to do this in the File tab, then Options menu, then the Advanced section. Alternatively, you can set Outlook to work offline until you are done setting up your merge. Now, we're ready to get properly started. We begin in Microsoft Word. We're using Office 2010, but this process is the same in Office 2013 and Office 365. Unless you want your email to be exactly the same for all your recipients, you don't need to write it before starting, as we'll see in a moment. On the Mailings tab, click on the Start Mail Merge and pick the Step-by-Step Wizard. The wizard appears on the right side of the screen. First, we pick the type of mail merge we'll be doing, which in our case is an email. Then we proceed to the next step using the link at the bottom right. Now we are asked what our email is going to be. We'll stick with using the current document, and in a moment we'll actually put something into it. The next step is to pick recipients, which is where our database comes in. With Use an existing list selected, click on Browse and then navigate to the Access database. You'll be given a choice of tables to find recipients in. In Accounts Guardian, the table we need is Address Book, so I'll pick that one. The next dialog shows you all the recipients it found in that table. I can choose to exclude particular people, or filter the list down to get a subset of the full list and just email them. We only want to send email to our customers, so I'll filter to cases where the customer field in my table is ticked in Accounts Guardian. I do this by clicking on Filter, then picking Customer as my field, using equal to as the comparison and true as the compared to value. I'll also filter for records where I actually have an email address, which I do by selecting email as the field and is not blank as the comparison. If you want to change who you're sending it to within your list, you can get back to that selection screen using the Edit Recipient List link in the wizard. Once you're happy with the list, proceed to the next step, where the wizard will ask you to actually write the email. The reason we wait until now to write is because if we write it after the connection to the database table has been established, we can use other information from that table as part of the email. So, for example, I'm going to start my email with Dear, then the salutation name of the person I'm emailing, for example, Mr. Smith. This is a field in the address book table, which I can get information from using the Insert Merge Field button on the Mailings tab. The field I need is Salutation. This field now appears in the email. When I complete the email merge later and thereby send the emails, each email will have the person's name at the start of it. As I write my email, I can do the same thing with any other information I have stored in that table as well. Something else to note is that when you send your email, it won't include any email signatures you usually have, so you need to manually include any sign-off you want to appear at the end of your emails at the bottom of the Word document. Once happy with the contents of the email, move on to the next step. This is a preview, where you can see how the information in your merge fields changes for each recipient, just to make sure it all works and looks as you'd expected. You can also still change the recipient list before we go on to send the emails if you notice you still have some incorrect people in there. The final step of the wizard is to complete the merge. It asks how you want to send the message. I'll pick my only option for email, which is, funnily enough, email. A pop-up appears where I can pick which field contains the recipient's email address, add a subject line to my emails, and set the format of the email, which is fine to just leave as HTML in most cases. I can also say to send only the email I'm currently previewing, or a set of emails based on the order the recipients appeared in our list earlier. For now, I want to send my email to everyone, so I'll leave that option selected. The filters I set up earlier will still be applied. This sends all the messages you need to send into Outlook into your Outbox. Check a few of them out to make sure you're happy with how they look, then click Send Receive to start the sending process. All done! All customers for whom I have an email address in my Accounts Guardian address book will now receive my message. You can save the Word document so you can easily do the email again in the future. The document will save with its links to the Account Guardian database and the filters, as well as the actual contents of the email. Hopefully this video has left you in a position to do an email merge for yourself, be it from Accounts Guardian or any other database containing contact information. If you found this video helpful, please consider giving it a like or leaving a comment to let us know. And to see more Excel, Access and VBA tutorials, subscribe to our channel or check out the link to our website in the description below. Thanks for watching.